freaking time.
Balls.co.za.
Well, the Castle Championship gets underway again this weekend. The Springboks taking on the Wallabies in Perth. The Boks currently on top of the table, but it's early days yet. And on the line chatting to us is Warren Whiteley, who we spoke to a few weeks ago. And Warren, the last time we chatted to you, you were getting ready to lead the Lions and we're just grateful for a time with the Boks. And lo and behold, the next day you get called up and here we are.
Yes, good morning. No, it's been fantastic. You know, a bit of a roller coaster, but I've got no complaints. You know, it's such a huge honor being here in the setup and just being in the 23 man squad this weekend. It's just an unbelievable feeling. So very excited.
Just level with me, Warren. Just level with me. That day that we spoke to you here on Ballz Radio, did you know at that time that you were actually going to get the call up?
No, I had absolutely no idea whatsoever. So I had no idea. I actually got the call, I think, that evening, you know. So I had absolutely no idea. It was, you know, a bit of a shock again to get the call, but it was fantastic. You know, definitely an exciting moment for me and my family.
Okay, so Heineke gives you the call and it says, you know, he wants you back in the squad to travel. Is there a potential for some game time now, or are you starting Saturday's game on the bench? What's the story?
No, look, I'm not sure what coach's plan is, but I'm just happy to be in a 23 man squad, and if an opportunity comes for me to get on the field, I'm going to take that with both hands and just give my best, you know. So it's just exciting for me to be here and to get a chance to play. You know, it's a dream come true and a huge honour.
And you get the feeling, or I do at least, I don't know about you, but heading into the game, that both the Springboks and the Wallabies have a point to prove. The Boks following on from that performance in Salta, and the Wallabies after that thrashing they got from the All Blacks.
No, look, we've been training really hard for the last 2 weeks and putting some hard work in, and the guys have trained well, good intensity, and there's a good vibe and excitement amongst the guys, and I think Australia is a quality side, you know, and especially being back home, it will motivate them even more, you know, to put a good performance together. But we're excited and looking forward to the challenge.
And yeah, I saw the Wallabies, they've announced their side, or they announced it yesterday, and we see them making three changes to the lineup. They've changed their scrum off. Nick Phipps, they've got Bernard Foley in at fly off and James Hansen at hooker. Did you guys see those changes coming?
Yeah, we saw those changes come in, and obviously it's a more settled lineup, you know, with the Waratahs guys, I think, now slotting it at 8, 9 and 10. You know, so it gives them more stability there, and they're a quality side, you know, they play a nice brand of rugby and at a high intensity. So we're looking forward to it this weekend.
What's been the talk in the camp in terms of our performance back in Salta? I know we spoke to you about it briefly, but I'm sure Heineke will have done his homework and come back with feedback. But what's been the chat in the change room? Because you can go, okay, well, it's Argentina. They like to play in a specific way, which might be harder to play an expansive game against. We mustn't beat ourselves up too much and get too concerned.
No, look, we weren't happy with the performance, obviously, and there were some areas that we really needed to focus on and work hard on, and I'm confident that the last 2 weeks we've really worked hard and had some real high-intensity training sessions, and it's gone well. You know, I think we've addressed those problems, and we look forward to this weekend where the real test comes. You know.
Yeah, and I suppose one of those areas must be the scrums. Although to be fair, you know, Argentina did scrum well. They didn't scrum badly.
Yes. No, a lot of credit has to go to them. They've got a very strong scrum traditionally, and they're always tough opponents, and they're worthy. You know, always have tough props, renowned props, you know, but we worked well the last 2 weeks. Spent a lot of time on the scrum machine, so there's been a lot of hard work going in there. So look forward to this weekend's scrums.
Okay, well, when we tried to phone you a little earlier on, De Jong said that the Aussie media had grabbed you for a quick chat. Just be careful they don't take your words and twist them into vile Aussie propaganda, because they do that.
I'll do that.
And you know, when Johnny told me that we were chatting to you, and I thought, oh, that's awesome, because he spoke to you the other day, but all I could think of was your girlfriend wearing your medal, your Commonwealth Games medal.
For my wife, you mean?
Yeah, maybe as your girlfriend got the other medal.
No. Only my wife. She's the bearer of that medal.
This is weird. The first thing that came to my mind was Warren's wife wearing his medal. And I thought, gee, if I could slip that into conversation somehow, that would be great.
Oh, my wish.
Well, listen, dude. We obviously... I'm very happy for you, and yeah, it was just uncanny that we happened to speak to you the day before you got your call up. So, yeah, so from us here at Ballz, good luck this weekend, and we'll be supporting you, man.
Thank you so much, and I appreciate all the support you guys have been giving, not only me, but also the Lions and the Springboks. You know, it's been amazing, so... thanks for everything.
And yeah, no, you're welcome, and pass on our best to the team. Give them a club. Not the team, the Aussies.
I will be. Okay. Cheers, man.
Cheers,
thanks very much.
Cool, man. Bye, bro. This is Visual Radio. Turn up! The official 2014 station. Ballz.co.za.